Welcome to the Separation Anxiety in Dogs Decoded podcast. I am your host, Ness Jones, and we'll be deep diving into all things separation anxiety. But before we get started, please make sure you like this episode, subscribe to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss another one. And don't forget, if you are interested in joining my easy step-by-step training program to resolve separation anxiety in your dog, you'll find the link in the show notes. Now let's get started. Hello, and we are back. And if you're watching this on YouTube, you'll see I have a dog on my lap. His name is Mr. Big, and he's not named after the Sex and the City, just by the by. He's just a big dog. He's oversized for his breed, but yes, he's licking me now. Anyway, in this week's episode, I want to talk about a question I get asked a lot, and that is, should I get another dog to keep my dog company? My dog's got separation anxiety. Should I get another dog? And it kind of touches on what we were talking about last week with the listener question from Nancy, where she said, what should she do when if one of her dogs passes? So should you get another dog? We don't know. So the reason I say that is we don't have the data, but sometimes it would be appropriate if you've got two dogs and one of them passes, then that might be a time if the remaining dog develops separation anxiety when they never had it before. It could be all they need is the company of another dog. But in general, if you've got a dog with separation anxiety and you're thinking about getting another dog, it's a big question mark whether it's going to help or not. So what you might end up with, your dog suddenly comes good and both the dogs are fine and your dog is quite happy with the company of another dog, and you suddenly get your life back and you no longer feel like a prisoner in your own home. Or getting another dog may have no impact whatsoever and your dog still has separation anxiety, but the other dog is fine to be left by itself. The third scenario would be that the new dog coming in picks up on the anxiety of your existing dog, and suddenly you've got two dogs with separation anxiety, which obviously is not a great outcome whatsoever. So what do we do, or what's the answer then? As I said, we don't know if it's going to help your dog or not. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. If it's an onset of separation anxiety because another dog has passed on, then, yeah, for sure it might be appropriate. However, if you do not want another dog, if you only want to have one dog, then don't get a dog for your dog, because then you've got another dog that you don't want. So for me, the best way of if you say, well, I am open to getting another dog, but I'm not if it's not going to work. Look, there's so many rescues out there looking for good fosters. They're desperate for fosters. So it could be a really special way of helping a dog until it finds a permanent home. And of course, there's always foster to adopt. So, you know, you can foster, you can do this wonderful thing to help out the rescues. And you can also find if your dog gets on with this new dog and look at the potential of fostering to adopt, because that's always the option, isn't it? You could be a foster fail and there's plenty of them. Obviously, if you're bringing in a new dog, you want your dog to get on with the new dog coming in. And, you know, there are times when it's just the wrong fit, in which case perhaps you swap that foster dog out for another foster dog. And it may just be finding the right dog for your dog. However, again, if it's not necessarily going to guarantee that your dog is fine, we don't know. And I guess that's the best way. Like, if you don't want to get another dog and then it doesn't help your dog, and then you've got two dogs and you didn't really want two dogs, because it's not always easy having more than one dog. I've got three, so I know for sure that it's not always easy. The other option is if you've got a friend that your dog gets along with, is to let that dog stay with your dog and leave them alone and see if that helps. Obviously, you're not going to go too far because you don't want your dog being over threshold, but it will give you an idea of whether your dog will do better with having a canine companion. And of course, it may not be a canine companion that you need. You may be, maybe your dog would be happy with a kitty cat or even a parrot. Who knows? But we don't, it's data we don't have. So we have to find out. So if you've got a friend that's got a dog and your dog gets along with their dog and they're happy to leave it at your place to find out, you've got that information then. And then if you do decide to get another dog, you can do that or foster to adopt. So if you don't want another dog, don't get one and just do the training. Go through the gradual exposure therapy and the desensitization to help your dog learn to be okay home alone. Again, just to reiterate, unless you've tried this, unless you've had another dog staying with your dog, we don't know. So you have to find out one way or the other. And that might be fostering, it might be a friend's dog. And that's the only way you're going to know. Is a little bit of this training is a little bit about data collecting. So what happens if X, Y, Z, and knowing how your dog is going to react to whatever that situation is, so we can adjust things accordingly for your dog. So hopefully that answers that question. It is, like I said at the beginning, it is one that I get asked a lot. And the question, the answer is we don't really know until we try it. You have been listening to Ness Jones on the Separation Anxiety in Dogs Decoded podcast. Don't forget to check out the show notes to learn more about my programs and how I can help you with tailored training. Until next time.